Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, agents. I am Mountie Carl, and you are listening to another Division Let's Talk, and we are skipping the intro today because I am just that excited to bring you what is going to be patch notes. And all I gotta say is, if you haven't watched the trailer that was put out today, Four Horsemen, F yeah, that's what I'm talking about. It looks effing exciting. I can't tell you how excited I am to be bringing you this Let's Talk, because I'm excited for this expansion that's going to drop tomorrow. We are just, you know, hours away from the expansion dropping on Xbox. Well, probably more than a few hours. I mean, it's coming out tomorrow. So I'm going to go over the patch notes with you that were released today and talk about some stuff. First of all, the trailer. If you haven't seen it, go watch it now. I'll put a link to it in the description. It looks effing awesome. Like, I mean, I'm sure that the Four Horsemen are from the Dragon's Nest incursion, but either way, it looks friggin' awesome. I can't believe it. It's so amazing. And I hope that some of you will at least add me on Xbox. I'm going to be rolling tomorrow, probably starting fairly early in the morning, going into the evening. So if you want to play with Mountie Carl, go ahead and add Cobra Khan on Xbox, and we will go ahead and try and get you into a group. I'll take as many people as I can through the underground with me. I'll be recording all day, but let's go ahead and get into the underground. There is a secret war going on in an uncharted and claustrophobic depths of Manhattan. Root out the threat and earn unique rewards. Explore the underground of New York in solo play or up to 4-player co-op. So all you solo people out there, this is for you. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. This is obviously made for solo play. As you know, they do scale it up. So if you have 4 people in a group, there's going to be more enemies. If you're going solo, there's going to be less enemies. Operations, experience randomly generated levels with all new environmental hazards and traps, which is cool. Stuff that we already knew about, directives, underground rank, all of this stuff is really, you know, things that we already knew. The one thing that you don't know is that your underground rank will earn you new directives, operation types, and exclusive vanity items. So all of those nice little turquoise drops that you've been getting, you won't get those anymore. You'll get them through your rank as you rank up. Now, the new incursion, Dragon's Nest. Travel to Hell's Kitchen to investigate rumors of a new cleaner weapon that can wreak havoc throughout Manhattan. Now, if you watch the trailer, you know that this is probably in regards to the Four Horsemen. And they're overarching, because the Four Horsemen are supposedly cleaners, and they are here to wipe out Manhattan, the virus, and everything. They just want the virus gone, so they are really going to go ahead and just wipe this out. Now, you need to have General Assembly done before you can do the incursion, and the incursion is balanced to do 4 players, not solo, and Heroic mode will come out 1 week after. Now, let's go ahead. There's new gear sets, of course, that we already know. Let's go over the ones that we don't really know. And they added, it says here that they added 4 new gear sets, and I'm sure that these are the 4 exclusive gear sets to exclusive to the Underground expansion, and then there's one that's exclusive to everybody in the 1.3 update. So let me just go ahead and we'll go over quickly. Blind, control the battlefield with improved pulse skill and flashbangs with the hybrid gear set. Deadeye, dictate long range engagements with powerful critical strikes and accurate headshots. Now, they're not really saying too much about what the perks are for this, but you know, as you can tell from going through this, this is just all stuff that they're just kind of going through. Firecrest, set your enemies ablaze with an offensive gear set, and Reclaimer, boost your entire group with the ultimate support set. So Blind is a control set, Deadeye is sniper, Firecrest is offensive, and Reclaimer is a support set. And they've added one new weapon, which is the Blind System MDR rifle. Please note that while it will be implemented in game, you will not be able to acquire it until future updates. So they are putting the Blind System MDR rifle in, but it won't be available until 1.4, which they said to us earlier. Now, following content changes and bugs are available on Xbox One and PC players on June 20th. Unfortunately, the patch is still delayed for PS4, so you can expect new stuff soon. All right, this is the one thing that you've all been waiting for. This is the patch set that drops for everybody, so when PS4 players get it, they're going to get all of this stuff on down, and PC players get this too. Even if you don't get the Underground expansion, you're going to get this stuff. So let's go ahead. Alpha Bridge, the gear set. Take advantage of all your equipped weapon talents with this powerful set. Now, there's still very little information that we know about the Alpha Bridge gear set, but it looks like it's going to be much better than the Nomad set. So looking forward to that. They've added 9 new weapon types. types in the game, the military G36, which I am personally looking forward to, the G36C auto assault rifle, G36 enhanced assault rifle. So there's three assault rifles there that are really just the same thing. So take it as you will. The surplus SVD marksman rifle, paratrooper SVD marksman rifle, PP19 machine gun or submachine gun, enhanced PP19 submachine gun, the X45 pistol, and the first wave X45 pistol. Now, really, there's only one or two of those if you're looking forward to it. There's really only two of those that people are looking forward to, and that's the G36, which is a lot of people are looking forward to it. I know I am, and the SVD marksman rifle, which seems pretty cool, but I don't know if it's going to be better than the M1A, so we'll see. And then there's a new high-end weapon called the Showstopper, which is a fully auto shotgun, which is going to be cool, especially with the shotgun changes. Now, the one thing that they added that they really didn't talk about is the heroic mode and challenge mode missions. Now, they added a challenge mode for the Hudson Refugee Camp and Queens Tunnel Camp. That's pretty cool. I enjoy both of those missions. Not so much Queens Tunnel Camp, but the Hudson Refugee Camp, that's actually pretty cool. That's the one that I did my underground footage on that I had. and then they added a new heroic mode difficulty to some of the, so if there's a challenge mode in the game right now, there will be a new heroic mode that you can do in addition to it, so you can fight stronger enemies to unlock top tier rewards. And the available missions are Refugee Camp, Queens Tunnel Camp, Russian Consulate, Lincoln Tunnel Checkpoint, Lexington Event Center, and Warren Gate Power Plant. I guarantee nobody's going to be doing the Warren Gate Power Plant because, well, that mission is one of the worst missions ever. And I'm sorry to say that, but really the whole timed portion of it, it just, you know, drives me nuts. Also, Heroic will be available for Falcon Lost, Clear Sky, and Dragon's Nest, but please note that Dragon's Nest Heroic Mode will be made available 1 week after the release for Underground owners. Daily missions do not support the Heroic difficulty. Now, the Base of Operations extension, for those of you buying the Underground, I don't know. I believe that 1.3, you will be getting the terminal. You just won't be getting the piece of it. So I don't know if it is that you're getting this or not. It's very much up in the air. They don't really say it. The terminal is a new shared social space inside the base of operations. The terminal can be found at the back of the base next to the reward claim vendor. Visit high-value contractors and all new vendors. The special equipment vendor has been split into two vendors within the terminal, items vendor and blueprint vendor. Players can also fast-track directly to the terminal. No more going outside of the boo. You can go directly into the terminal. Now, I'm pretty sure that the terminal is for everybody, because the Tactical Operations Center is the one where you go down into the underground. So I'm pretty sure the terminal is for everybody. 1.3, you get the terminal, you get all of this stuff. Oprah is handing out all of this stuff to 1.3 patch players. So if you play, you're going to get all this stuff. Now, you're not going to get the underground stuff. So if it was in the underground, you're not going to get that. Now, you can recalibrate. Also, let's go ahead, move on. Weapon recalibration. You can now recalibrate one of the weapon talents at the recalibration bench. Recalibrating a weapon requires weapon kits and Phoenix credits. Weapon kits can be acquired through drops in the game, or they can be crafted. So that's pretty awesome. Go ahead and recalibrate their stuff. Now, let's go ahead and go over the gameplay stuff that they added a new Dark Zone bracket. We all thought they were going to add a new Dark Zone area. No, they're just going to add a new Dark Zone bracket for people that are gear score 231 plus. Now, I'm at 228, so it's not going to be too hard to hit that 231 number, which is going to be a little scary, because from what I've heard, it's actually the guys down in DZ1 are going to be level 32 going all the way up to level 36 from what I have heard. So it's going to be very, very, very difficult in the Dark Zone as of late. Player stash size has been increased to 70 total slots. I know a lot of people were really excited about this, but they wanted more, especially with now that we have three complete gear set releases, and everybody knows that your slots have been filling up lately. Now, level 30 players will now only encounter level 30 or higher enemies in free roam. So if you're in free roam, level 30, no more level 25s. Level 25 was the old level cap that you would see. Now you will see only level 30s. Rebalanced NPCs weak points to be more consistent across the board. This impacts the amount of damage needed to trigger them, which is actually good, because if you're level 34, I shouldn't have to shoot you more times than a level 32, especially in the back. It should trigger on the thing. So now you can convert. Oh, here's the big thing that people need to know. And this is huge. So please take note of what I'm about to tell you. You can now convert three high-end division tech to one of any high-end crafting material. Let me say that again. Three high-end division tech, one high-end crafting material. A 3-to-1 transfer. Hallelujah for all of us who are maxed out and have 999 high-end division tech. This is going to be great. So take my advice. Save all of your caches if you're maxed out at 999. Save all of them and go through and you convert all of your division tech tomorrow and then go and open your caches so you just get a new refill on that. This is going to be awesome. This is going to change the way crafting works. It's really the one thing that was needed for crafting, and now that we have it, it's going to be awesome, and you're going to see a lot more use and a lot more ability to craft things, especially with all these new blueprints coming out. Now, they have reduced the Phoenix credit cost for 204 high-end and 240 gear set items and blueprints. The special equipment vendors in the tech wing only sells items now and will no longer sell blueprints. They will be blueprints vendors in the terminal. You can no longer share an item that you have equipped. This was a bug. If you had something equipped, you could still share it. Adjustments have been made to the NPC threat list, these are all very important. Please listen to these, because this is Ubisoft listening to the things we have told them, and this is them doing a great job. And actually, I'm not even going to get Ubisoft credit. This is massive. Specifically listening to the player base and saying, these are the things you need to fix to kind of remove our headaches. They are making adjustments to the NPC threats that cause players to stay in combat for large periods of time. You will now leave combat after reaching a certain distance away from the enemy or after a set amount of time. So now, no longer will you have to sit outside the door and have it say you're still in combat. You're not going to do that anymore. So hallelujah, that has been great. Players will now disconnect from the game after they've been inactive for 15 minutes. This is give or take. It didn't really matter to me. It didn't affect me at all. So it's all right. Players can now matchmake inside no spawn areas and can fast travel into activities while the group is in a no respawn area. I know that they had prevented this before because of the glitching and stuff like that, but it looks like they fixed whatever it was that was glitching. You can no longer kick a group member in a boss fight. Oh my goodness. The assholes who run YouTube channels that purposely exploit this, you no longer have an audience. Here's a big middle finger for you. Please go kill yourself. I honestly have no love for you. People that record videos of you kicking them just for a laugh in YouTube view so that you could get loot. You are worse than the a-hole rogues that I talk about. I would rather run and be killed 200 times than ever party or watch any of your channels. Honestly, you are the worst. You are the scumbag of the internet. People who kick people at the end of missions so they get screwed out of loot. You know the guy that I'm talking about. I'm not going to say his name, but honestly, big middle finger to you, because you can no longer exploit this game for your 12-year-old fan base who likes to watch people's misery. So now all players must be present in the final circle of clear sky before you can interact with the laptop and fuses. NPCs located in the final circle in clear sky will instantly respawn once killed until players enter the area. So no more exploiting that from the outside. So I know that I didn't post this exploit, but I know that prior to tomorrow's patch, you were able to shoot through the blue tarp and kill enemies and then go inside and then go ahead and grab that. Players can no longer deploy mobile cover skill while they're performing a cover, another glitch fix. They're doing a great job. And exotic damage resilience is now capped at 90%, so that you're no longer invincible while you're in while you have 100% damage resilience. So that's great. They did a lot to really nail down fixing a lot of the glitches that people were complaining about, I actually haven't seen too many people glitching at all in the last couple of weeks. Of course, the Dark Zone's been very limited. Today it actually picked up, and as you can see, thank you so much to the guys that were running with me today. I picked them up while I was just in there running solo. They came up to me, they wanted to be part of the group, and so I joined them and ran around with them, as you can see. So big hats off to those guys. You can see their names in fun game. Go ahead and these are friendly guys. You can join them and have a good time with them. They were cool. Did not be, you know, they weren't a-holes in the slightest. So pretty cool. So, all right, let's move on. Weapons. These changes only impact weapons acquired after the update 1.3, unless stated otherwise. So they added unique bonuses to several weapon families. Now, this won't affect anything that you currently have in your stash. All of this, you will need to go into the Dark Zone or go into one of these other areas and pick up an LMG shotgun or an assault rifle. The LMG increased damage to targets out of cover by X percent. Now, previously it was 25%. Now it says X percentage. So I assume that it's going to be level based on what gear score your LMG is at. They probably thought that 25% might be too much, so they might have lowered it down. Who knows? We won't see. We won't be able to see until tomorrow what the actual percentage is. I know that I have my LMG God roll, but we're going to have to wait and check that out tomorrow and see what that is. Shotguns added a chance to stagger NPCs. This will not affect other players. As I said before, they don't have the mechanics to affect other players yet, but they said in the coming patches, they will try to make this happen. And assault rifles added an enemy armor damage bonus. This is not impact damage done to other players. Now, change the weapon bonus on NPC SMGs from a percent crit hit chance to a percent crit hit damage. Increase the base damage of shotguns. Decrease the damage done by Augen Vector by 10%. This impacts all new and existing ones. So if you have an Augur or Vector, it's going to affect you right away. Increase the minimum accuracy cap on the M1A. When shooting consistently, the crosshairs will grow much larger in size than it previously did. This impacts all new and existing M1As. Damage done by explosive bullets has been reduced. Now it does a 1-to-1 explosive. So if you hit for 30,000, the damage is going to be equal to 30,000. Not a big problem there. You know, the damage done by explosive bullets was only really affecting the bolt-action sniper rifles where you could one-hit somebody. The status effect on incendiary bullets has been reduced to 3 seconds from 10 seconds. Now, you're not going to find that actually in the notes. That's something that I basically just said because I know what they already are. Now, here's some more important stuff to notice. These are the nerfs to the set pieces, and I don't actually consider them nerfs because in order for them to consider them nerfs, they need to make the gear worse, but they actually aren't. They're actually making it a little bit better. So let's go ahead and dive in. Every gear piece now has a set number of mod slots that can be recalibrated. Now this is kind of something that does make it worse because I know that I had a chest piece with 3 mod slots. I don't know how it's going to affect, but this only affects gear that drops after update 1.3. So I had a chest piece that had 3. It will stay the same. Chests now are maxed out at 2 mod slots. Masks will now have 1 mod slot, knee pad 1 mod slot, and backpacks 1 mod slot. You will no longer be able to get 2 mod slots on each of those. So sorry to say that, but it will be all right. Holsters, this is a huge bonus. Holsters will now always have 3 attributes. That is awesome because I know a lot of people, I have a lot of gear that has a lot of crappy rolls, and I would love to have holsters that were 240 plus that had 3 mod slots and I can't use them, or 3 attributes, because I couldn't use them because they didn't have 3 slots. They only had 2, and they would have brought my stats down significantly. Now let's go over the nerfs that were talked about with Sentry's Call and Striker. Now this is really, you know, this nerf was really put in place to kind of wean people away from really running 2-2-2 and 3-3 with Sentry and Strikers. Now the Sentry and Strikers battle gear sets have had their 2 sets and 3 set bonuses reduced, and we've added a new 5 set bonus. The 4 set bonuses have not been changed. So there's a 4 set bonus, there's a 2, a 3, a 4, and a 5 set bonus for these. So it's a nerf, but it's not really a nerf. So the previous Sentry's Call bonuses were 2 set, were 30% headshot damage, and 3 set, 20% damage to elites. I think that's wrong, actually. I thought it was 20% headshot damage. So especially since now Sentry's Call bonuses are 2 set is 10% headshot damage, 3 set is 10% damage to elite, and a 5 set is 20% headshot damage and a plus 10% damage to elites. So I'm guessing that that all stacks, so you'll get 30% headshot damage and 20% damage to elites when you have a 5 set Sentry's Call. Striker's battle gear bonuses, 20% Previously, they were 2-set 20% enemy armor damage, 3-set 50% critical hit damage, which is a little bit insane. So now they have changed that to a 2-set is 10% enemy armor damage, 3-set 20% critical hit damage, and the 5-set is 10% enemy armor damage and 30% critical hit damage. So basically what they've done is they've changed the 2 and 3 sets to make it so you have to have 5 to get the full bonus for what you used to be able to get with 3 and 3. Now, I know a lot of you running Sentry and Strikers, you have to redo your gear now, but it's not that bad. You'll figure out a new gear set. There's tons of new gear sets. There's tons of new iterations. You'll figure it out. I moved on from the Sentry Strikers a while ago because I anticipated this, and I was trying to already look ahead and organize my gear, so I run 2 Lone Star, 2 Sentry, and 2 Final Measure, and it works out great. The Dark Zone. Let's go ahead and talk about the Dark Zone. We all thought that the Dark Zone was getting a new instance beyond DZ6, but it's not. There's a new 231 gear Dark Zone for bracket for more powerful NPCs. The DZ 1 through 2, I know I think I said it's going to be 32. No, it's going to be 33. DZ 3 and 4 are going to be 34, and DZ 5 and 6 will be level 35. So there won't be any level 36. The DZ 5 and 6 in gear score bracket 201 to 230 will now have a chance to drop gear score 229 high ends and 268 gear sets. Let me say that again. The gear score bracket 201 plus, that is below 231 plus, anything in DZ 5 and 6 will have a chance of dropping a gear score 229 high-end weapon or equipment or high-end or whatever it is, and a 268 gear set. So there you go. Dark Zone chests will now scale better with the gear score bracket and the name zone that you are in. Now let's go ahead and talk loot changes. The high risk value targets have had their rewards and difficulty adjusted to take into account the new gear score increase, normalized loot drops from main mission and challenge mode. Cadaceous will now drop from hard mode mission bosses. Normal mode missions will now drop superior items instead of the high-end items. Green Division tech will no longer drop in the Dark Zone after level 30. UI changes, they've added a base weapon damage value that makes it easier to compare weapons. So now there's a base damage value. No more of this scaling up to meet whatever need it is. The gear mods and weapon mods are now combined in the same inventory display. Added a new inventory slot for miscellaneous, which I have no idea what miscellaneous is. It could be skins, it could be something like that. And they improve the visibility of supply drops on the mega map. In the Dark Zone. So all good stuff. So let's go ahead, let's talk about bug fixes. We'll close it up. I knew this was going to run a little bit longer, but what do you expect? The eve before a brand new patch drops. They fixed a bug where the 4-set predator bleed effect would no longer trigger the shrapnel player talent. Fixed a bug where players using a med kit while having the combat medic status equipped will result in displaying allied skills proxy, which is the smart cover thing, if you ever encountered that. So now combat medic isn't going to destroy the smart cover. They fixed a bug where using a med kit while having the combat medic status equipped would heal the player using the 40% more health instead of just their allies. Fixed a bug with EMP grenades would not trigger the final measure 4-set diffuse effect. Now, I'm pretty sure none of the grenades except for hand grenades would trigger that. So if they just fixed that, well, I have no idea. They fixed a bug where the Operation ISAC timer was shown the incorrect time. Predatory weapon talent now correctly uses the player's health as the base of the healing amount instead of the target's health. Fixed a bug where the Survival Link signature skill would increase the movement speed while moving backward and carrying an item. Sorry for all those people who ran this in the in Clear Sky. It no longer will work. Sorry to say. Fixed a bug where the Ballistic Shield would lose its hitbox after the player performed a roll move. Fixed a bug where the ballistic shield would become invisible after opening and closing the inventory. Fixed a bug where the pulse would sometimes not detect NPCs in range. Fixed a bug that caused loot containers to sometimes not be detected by pulse when using the recon pack modification. Fixed a bug that allowed players to go through objects by deploying the mobile cover. Awesome. More stuff they're fixing. NPC skirmishes would start while the supply drop event was underway in the same location. Fixed supply drop notifications and mission tracker inconsistency. Fixed a bug that allowed explosive bullets to sometimes damage players behind cover. Fixed a bug. There's lots of bug fixes. I'm not going to go through them all because it's such a huge list and we are running out of time, but pretty much we went ahead and covered most of this stuff. So I'm just trying to see if there's anything. There's some PC specific improvements. The most important thing in the game, guys. This is by far the most important thing, and it's going to change your world as you know it. They fixed the bug where the moon was upside down. If that's not the funniest thing ever that they fixed, that is a great fix. I honestly had no idea there was even a moon in the game, so that's great. Anyways, that has been my time. I look forward to playing with some of you tomorrow. This is going to be a great expansion. I am super excited about it. If you haven't played it yet, or not played it yet, because you haven't played it yet, but if you haven't bought it yet, I am looking forward to it. I hope my excitement has at least encouraged some people to go out and at least try it and get it. Honestly, Ubisoft should just allow you to play it. Sorry to PS4 players, because I know that, I said, hey, you PS4 players get a whole month to kind of evaluate whether or not you want to get it. Psych, you guys are sucking it out. I'm sorry. You guys lose out. Like, it sucks. I know it sucks. I'm sorry. I can't contain my excitement. It does suck for PS4 players, because tomorrow you can't play it, but you'll get to play it August 2nd. You'll get to see all the stuff that we like. And I'm very sorry. Like I said, go to Costco, buy an Xbox One, play it for a month, and then take it back. Because Costco gives a 100% refund or something like that. There are ways to get around it. It's going to be awesome tomorrow being able to play it. And I'm sorry, I will try to contain my excitement here for PS4 players, especially with you not even being able to get the 1.3 patch. But I'll try and post some screenshots and stuff like that in my feed, and I'll try and post a lot of stuff tomorrow while I'm playing. That way you guys can kind of see what's going on and get a feel for the game and stuff like that. I'm sorry, PS4 players. My heart goes out to you. My PS4 is collecting dust. It's sitting right here. It's collecting dust, and it's going to collect dust for another month and until No Man's Sky comes out. So anyways, that has been my time. I've been Mounty Carl. Thank you so much for listening. I'm very excited to be playing this with some of my subscribers tomorrow. I already have some lined up that want to play with me and that have sent me a message. Feel free to send me a message over Xbox Live. The gamer tag is all over this place. You can find it in almost any video. It should be in the description as well. It's CobraCon on Xbox. And we will see you tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching this video in its entirety. I know it's longer than we normally have, but we will catch you next time on a Division Let's Talk. I'm sure that we will have a lot. I have a whole toughness guide that I've been working on, but I'm kind of working through it just to try and get it out for tomorrow, or get it out sometime this week, and be prepared to kind of change it around for stuff that we see in tomorrow's patch. So anyways, I'm out of here. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you on the Underground. Agent out.